Hi everyone, my name is Peter Kwiatkowski, and today's video will be about cigar smoking in cinema. We start off with James Bond, as this character is so strongly connected with cigar world. For example, Roger Moore actually had in his contract that while filming James Bond movies, he will receive an unlimited supply of Monte Cristo's number 2. In the scene, we can see James Bond walking into a cigar factory in Cuba.
I'm here to pick up some delectados.
To pick up some cigars called delectados. Those cigars didn't exist at the moment of filming this movie. They appeared later after the premiere. One of Brazilian companies actually introduced those cigars. In this scene, we can also see a guy reading a daily newspaper to factory workers. This is actually something that is happening even today in Cuba.
Seven, Madame wins.
I hope the third is where your real talent lies.
I chose this scene from GoldenEye to show that cigar smoking in cinema is not only a man's thing. It's also something for strong, independent and dominant women, as seen on the screen Ksenia Onatopp.
Madame starts with 5. 6. Madame loses.
Since we are talking about strong and independent characters, I just couldn't resist putting Arnold Schwarzenegger into this compilation. He is a huge cigar fan. He smokes on screen and in his private life. He loves Cuban cigars. And basically what's interesting for me is that you could actually put in his place almost every action movie actor from Hollywood. Sylvester Stallone, Bruce Willis, Dan Trejo. You pick one, you pick the one. They all smoke and love cigars.
Looking good, Dutch. It's been a long time, General. Come on inside.
Cigar smoking on screen is also for sci-fi and fantasy characters. Here we have the comedian from a DC Comics universe, a rather black character. Anyway, this is not my favorite cigar-smoking guy from fantasy world. My favorite cigar guy is Wolverine from Marvel Universe.
Excuse me, I'm Eric Lentra.
Charles Xavier.
Go fuck yourself.
Okay, with all those claws, you would think he would cut his cigar and not bite its end off. Here is a scene from Hellboy. If you've read comics, then you know that the main character is often seen with a short cigar in his mouth. And this scene is all about that.
What are you doing? Come on.
You never light a cigar that way.
You use a wooden match. Preserves the flavor, you see?
Thank you.
Thank you.
And here is something for Robert Rodriguez fans. Peace,
and I don't shoot anymore.
You don't shoot any less either.
I don't see you,
hear from you in 3 years? And now you want me to help you kill all these men?
Yes, bro. I mean, Padre.
I'll see what I can do.
I want you to say 10 Our Fathers and 10 Hail Marys. Light a candle for Mom. For funerals, little side business. I had these installed when too many things started walking away from the altar and collection plants.
Imagine if we had this kind of setup when we were federales.
This is how you get the bad guys now. You catch them on video. Cuban?
Mexican.
Oh, yeah, I got some of that.
This scene is kind of sad, but I've picked it because it shows a very interesting gesture. The gesture of sharing tobacco. It's not just something that you'll see on a movie screen or in television. It's something that's actually historical. During the First World War, they used to stop battles so soldiers could exchange cigars, cigarettes, and pipe tobacco and smoke together. I think this is just something beautiful and incredibly interesting. Here is my favorite cigar smoking scene from Black Hawk Down, and you will hear in a minute a phrase that that is famous among cigar aficionados, not only in the United States.
No, no, thanks, I got one.
These are Cuban. Bolivar, Bellicoso.
So's this.
Miami, my friend, is not Cuba.
Okay, that's all for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.